All right, so you're homeless right now, and why is that? Because of the drugs? Okay, so tell me about your addiction. Like, so what's the worst thing you ever done to get high, to make it happen? Have you ever been in prison? This is Ask Pharmacist Tish. I am here in the beautiful city of Charlotte, North Carolina. So what is your name is what now?
My name is Frank.
And where are you from, Frank?
I'm actually from Syracuse, New York, 315 Lexington Avenue.
And so how long you been in Charlotte, North Carolina?
I've been here since 2008.
2008?
Well, it's a great city. That's why I'm still here.
All right. Yes. Now I heard the rumors on the streets that you are above average. You're super smart. You're brilliant. That's not true. You're average.
They're below average.
So what made you come down? So how old were you when you came down to Charlotte?
I was 29, about 2008.
Well, how old are you now?
46.
Okay, you look great. All right, so you're homeless right now, and why is that? Because of the drugs?
You know how hard that was for me to admit it, though.
Yeah.
But like I said, this is like
therapy. It's therapy for you? A lot of times when you talk about something, then you be ready to move on from it. Do you want to be on drugs?
Okay.
All right. You're going to give us a beginning, okay?
2014.
Mm-hmm. And I'm repeating everything you say because it's hard to hear. Okay.
I sold drugs all my life.
Okay.
My wife cheated on me.
Okay.
So she came home and we argued, whatever, but she, like, I didn't cheat. I didn't, we just used to chill. I didn't, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And her sister calls and tells. So I didn't want to hit her. I'm thinking all the worst things I can do. I didn't want to put my hands on her. I'm furious.
Mm-hmm. And I'm sorry, let me ask, why do you think she cheated on you? Did you see it? Are you hurt?
I mean, she's sharp. You think, you know, she's sharp.
Okay.
You know, I deserved it. I deserve it.
Why you say that? Were you cheating as well, or?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, so hold up. So, you were always cheating, and then when she cheated, there was a problem.
Yeah.
But you cheated.
Yeah.
Okay.
I cried. I called my grandmother crying.
Wow, you don't seem like the crying type.
I called my grandmother crying.
Mm-hmm.
True story.
Mm-hmm.
True story.
All right. So you said this because of that kind of started your addiction.
I was getting to it, but yeah. So she whatever her sister called me, she cheated. She told me, yeah, she did whatever. And I'm thinking, I didn't want to hit her, so I'm thinking anything, I could do anything. So she didn't really smoke weed, man. She hit a blunt every now and again. We were alcoholics.
Okay.
We drank a fucking gallon of vodka every day. Her shit got out of control.
Okay.
Her alcohol. But she like, yo, just roll a blunt.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we argue. Just roll a blunt, chill.
Mm-hmm.
She got her now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I went in the kitchen, rolled up a motherfucking blunt, put a 40 crack.
Mm-hmm.
And this should have been an indicator to her. Because I handed to her the lighter, like this.
Mm-hmm.
She lit it, and I just sat back on the dresser and just watched.
Mm-hmm.
She didn't know what the fuck she was doing, and that's why I'm suffering.
Mm-hmm.
So she got it down to about there.
Okay.
And I said, this is what he's doing. She shrugged her shoulders and hit it again.
Oh, wow.
She And there goes the neighborhood.
And so from there it was on and popping. So yeah. So basically, because you had so much pain and hurt from the cheating and probably all the stuff you went through as your child. Because you had a partner in crime, basically. And so ever since then, the crack problem just got worse and worse. So how did you end up on the streets then, if y'all were together doing it?
She what? She wasn't doing it. I was there.
Okay.
I ended up on the streets because I don't want to go to my mom.
Okay. You don't want to go to your mom?
Because I let me use that. You know what I'm saying? I'm not responsible. I am, but I'm, you know.
You just want to be your own man, do your own thing. So you'd rather be on the streets? You'd rather be homeless than to go to your be with your mom or your wife?
They need me right now. Someone says that.
Okay.
They need me right now. My mom is 70 years old. And she needs me to drive me. And they want me back fast right now.
What?
Especially going to get my hair done at my house someday.
Right.
And hopefully, you know, I'll make that trip. But,
Okay, so tell me about your addiction. Like,
it's
so.
Rough.
What's the worst thing you ever done to get high, to make it happen?
Hey, I mean, you know.
You say, hey.
Wow. Still, I ain't no way. Nah, I haven't crossed that level. I never will. I lost everything but my manhood.
Okay.
And that's a true story. But I robbed him. I have to rob that motherfucker to get money.
Have you ever been in prison?
I haven't.
You say have not?
I haven't.
Okay, yeah. So you just have a addiction problem. Do you want to be cured?
I'm about to be cured.
How? Yeah, how you gonna do? You go to a rehab?
All I got is a daily reprieve and this attention to my spiritual needs.
Okay. So you want to end your addiction?
It's gonna end.
I'm sorry?
It's gonna end. It's inevitable. But, it's going to
happen. I know, but...
This was a humbling experience.
Okay.
This is the way my father humbled me, teaching me gratitude and acceptance, preparing me for what he has in store for me.
Mm-hmm. How long you been homeless again, you said?
2 years.
2 years? And you're tired? You're tired of the life?
Not joy and honor. I can say that.
Okay. Yeah, it's not like you just get a joy. It's some crap that comes along with it that you don't want with it, right? So are you going to go to a rehab center?
I did that.
And what happened?
Last year, I crashed. My baby mother came and picked me up February 15th of last year.
Mm-hmm.
And I moved out to Charleston with them.
Okay.
And it didn't work. You know what I'm saying?
It didn't work at all?
It didn't. It didn't. She dropped me off.
So you just need a good program or something. Well, you need the will. You need the will to find.
I wanted to. I just gotta say no.
Right. I mean, but you know, it causes a sickness where it's hard to say no.
Yeah, it doesn't.
Right. Right. I believe you. Right. So, anything you want to share with the city of Charlotte? How is the homeless communities like?
Horrible. And I pray for them.
Mm-hmm.
I pray so much for my brothers and sisters out here.
Mm-hmm. So, hold up. So, you're homeless, but you still have enough heart to think and pray for other people?
My father walked me through this.
Mm-hmm. When you say my father, who is that? In heaven? Yeah. I just want to clarify to people who's going to see it. All right, so, you know, you said 43 years old. You've been homeless for a couple of years, but you finally come to the understanding that you do have an addiction. and you're ready to move on from it. A lot of times when you have an addiction, it's because you're trying to escape something that's painful, or trauma.
Society is what I'm trying to see.
And what about society?
Society, that's what I'm trying to see. You know what I'm saying? I'm on these streets 24/7.
I mean, but when you were a child, you used then, what were you trying to fight then? What were you trying to escape from?
That's a great question. That's something for me to ponder on.
Because
I swear, what are you, a sponsor? Is that my fourth step or something like that?
Thank
you. That is truly something for me to think about.
Yeah.
See, now this is dope. You tried to put me in a quagmire, like I asked.
That's not true.
It is, and I love it.
Uh-huh.
I'm truly grateful, man.
Well, I appreciate you. I appreciate you sharing your story.